Detrás de una gran producción, por supuesto, hay un director que se ha encargado desde el día uno de llevar todos los detalles para que la película sea mágica. Y eso es lo que hace el director Bill Condon en la película La Bella y la Bestia. Bill, hola, un placer.
Hola.
It's
hola.
A pleasure. How are you?
So good, so good. So glad to be here.
I'm a fan of yours since a lot of time, since Gods and Monsters, Chicago, Dreamgirls, all the great movies you've been doing, Kinsey, all the great movies you've been doing along your career, your successful career. What does it take to be a great director? What is the key element in a career of a director?
Oh my God. You know what I think? Finally, it's got to be, you have to connect deeply with the material in some way and find yourself in the material. I know for me here, the fact that Belle and the Beast are both such misfits and outsiders is something I connect to, especially the Beast and his predicament, the kind of prison he's made for himself. I find that very interesting, and it's very similar to other characters that I've examined before.
How did you get involved with Beauty and the Beast, La Bella y la Bestia? I know, we know, you've been doing some musicals, some very successful musicals, and this is a very famous musical.
Yes.
And it was like a big challenge for a director to get in charge of this beloved movie.
Right, well, you're right. The thing is that this is actually, as opposed to the others, it's a remake of a musical that already exists that people love. That's a perfect movie, right? Mm-hmm. And I had to only think of it as a new thing. You know, it's sort of, because it's in the live action world, everybody being played for real and human actors, that suddenly we could look at the story in a different way, you know? But what excited me was that also with Disney behind us, that we got to make it at the scale that it needed to be made.
There is something great about this movie. It's a live action, but sometimes it gets me mixed up with the live action because we have CGI in the movie.
Right,
so
right,
it's not
right.
That live action right. As supposed to be. But what was the biggest challenge for you to bring to life these
right,
characters?
Right. Well, the thing is, it is live action and it's photo real, right? So even when there are animated things, CG plates and teapots and things like that, I think they've been done, these wizards who, you know, now the technology is available to us, so that you actually believe that there's this thing standing between us. Mm-hmm. You know, that's the crucial thing that I hope that people are able to forget about all that and treat it as though it's a real tale, you know?
You succeed at that.
Okay.
It looks real. Everything is real. And for the story, we see a little changes.
Sure.
Who was in charge of that? Disney say, oh, you can change this or you can change that, or make a color copy of the original.
No, actually, they were, when they hired me, they said, go make your movie. You know, they checked in, obviously, but that was something they let me do. And they understood, I don't think Disney has any interest in making carbon copies of their movies.
Yeah.
You know, that why they've already got that movie, you know. So again, that with their encouragement, I took it and turned it into something that made sense in 2017 and that made sense in a live action format.
I love the characters. They come to life in a different way from what we saw in the animated movie. The Beast, we're going to talk to him today, and he's like the main element of this movie. Not to say that the beauty
sure.
isn't, but this is the story about the Beast, about his process, about what
right.
he's changed into your life, and the message
right.
that he's going to get away to the moviegoers is from the Beast. Did you try to add something else, something extra to the experience and the message that people is going to take out?
Yeah, there's a lot. The Beast is very different from the one in the animated film. For one thing, he's not illiterate, you
mm-hmm.
know? If you remember, that Beast, you know, he was like a grown-up, that made him cute, but he was like a grown-up kid, and he never learned how to read,
yeah.
and he still had the kind of instincts and emotions of a child, you know? And this is a man who had grown to adulthood and was very, very well-educated, and also kind of, you know, extremely kind of blasé about everything. He'd seen it all, you know. So that's where Dan Stevens was such a great choice, because he's somebody who can, obviously he's got charm and romantic kind of appeal, but also he can go very dark, and he's also somebody who's very worldly, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, the whole idea was that we, you know, I think the Beast, his kind of inability to be loved and to love somebody else. That is the most powerful change, I think, in the movie.
One of the biggest challenges, I think, for Disney and for you as a director was to cast the perfect Belle.
Yes.
How was choosing Emma Watson for this role?
It was easy, I hate to say. You know,
really?
I feel like, I don't even think, it's so obvious, isn't it? I mean, the good thing is that it turned out to be as right as it seemed to be on paper, you know? She's a great actor, she's beautiful, she loves this role, it means something to her, she's an activist herself in real life. All those things converged, you know, in that choice.
Do you mind about comparisons? People comparing the first one to this one? Well, not the first one, the original one.
Yeah. I think it's inevitable, right? We're redoing that, you know. But I hope that, and I think it's, you know, it's part of, I find that, you know, people probably watch this for about 10 minutes, like, okay, that's Gaston in this. That's what the Beast is like. You know, you have to, when you know something that well, you have to get used to the new thing. And I found that by the end, people are realizing it is a different movie. And then hopefully, you know, it's the kind of movie that people would see a second time and then take entirely on its own terms.
What are you taking away from your experience for having the Beauty and the Beast back on the screen?
Oh, you know, that's what I love. I loved when it came out initially, and it's such a great kind of expression, I think, of joy and also of some important themes. And it's great to be able to share that with this whole new generation of people.
Yeah, it's great. And we're very glad. Do you intend to do another Disney classic? Would you like to?
Well, you know, I keep saying that it's like this. I got, to my mind, the best. You know, this really is my favorite. So it'd be hard to touch this in my mind.
Okay. Well, thank you. It's a great movie. Thank you
very much. Thank you. Thank you so much.
What a pleasure.